Let's again discuss about globalization and its critics, nature of globalization. The first is liberalization. Liberalization stands for open competition and free trade, and these are important characteristics of globalization. Globalization is based on principle of liberalization, or in other words, we can say that liberalization is a tool to give practical shape to the process of globalization, you can say. Because liberalization gives freedom to industrialists to establish their industrial unit and decontrol or deregulation and delicensing, etc., are its basic principle. So, liberalization was responsible for industrial revolution and spread of capitalism in Europe, and today liberalization is an important pillar of globalization, you can say. In simple word, we can say that we can't think of globalization in the absence of liberalization, as both are two sides of same coin. ये कह सकते हैं कि बिना liberalization के हम globalization को सोच भी नहीं सकते. जैसे एक सिक्के के दो पहलू होते हैं, like that. Next is privatization. Privatization is a second important characteristic of globalization. Privatization stands for giving primacy to private sector over the public sector. The industrialists are free to install industry unit, and public sector is completely open to for private sector. In beginning, partnership is establishing between public and private sector. And later on, public sector is completely converted into private sector. So the limitations of the private sector are relaxed and licensing system is abolished. So that's why this is the entire world become a playing field for the industrialist, as they can establish their industries in any part of the world. Next is dominant role of multinational companies. Dominant mean to say bossism. Dominant role of multinational MNC is also an important characteristic of globalization. We have read that globalization give preference to private sector in comparison to public sector, as a result of which MNC get opportunity to spread their network all over the world. MNC establish their agencies in different part of the world, and this way these play an important role of give practical shape to globalization. So that's why students, everybody want to invest their money in the other countries too, you can see. So that's why today major proportion of international trade is under the control of MNC, and these are driving forces of international market, you can see. Next is integration of domestic market. Integrate mean to say ekjut hona. So domestic market mean local market. So integration of domestic market with global economy. The integrate democratic economy with global economy is an important characteristic of globalization. Simple meaning of globalization is globalization of the market, which mean to integrate the domestic market of all countries with global market, and the rules of global market will regulate the conduct of domestic market. It will limit the economic autonomy of nation, as they wouldn't be able to regulate their domestic economy according to their wish. Today, the to regulate global economy rules are made and enforced by World Trade Organization, and the member nation are bound to obey these rules. Next is dominant role of international institution. Which is the international institution? IMF, WB and WTA. Today, there are so many international organizations such as World Trade Organization, International Monetary Fund, and International Labour Organization, United Nations Council of Trade Development, UNICAD, UNDP, WTO, the World Bank, etc. So after establishment of World Trade, WTO, you can say, in 1995, process of globalization has become very fast and strong. Next, global movement of people, free movement of people at world level is also characteristic of globalization. The condition for movement of people, entrepreneurs, experts, professionals and laborers, etc., have been relaxed considerably, as a result of which during the last few years, international movement of people has increased manifold. As a result of this, culture integration at world level has become strong, and multiculturalism has become an important characteristic of globalization. Is that clear? Now, free flow of international capital. Free flow of international capital of international level is also an important characteristic of globalization. According to many people, globalization is globalization of financial capital, you can say. As a result of this, the capital investment in developing country from developed countries has increased manifold. It has helped the strengthening their domestic economy today. Finance capital has been able to spread its root almost all over the world in it, and the role played by international financial institutions cannot be ruled out. The free flow of international capital is also known as liberalization of financial capital, you can say.